गुड मॉर्निंग स्टूडेंट, लेट अस रिवाइज सम ऑफ द इम्पॉर्टेंट टॉपिक रिलेटिंग टू चैप्टर 1, दैट इज फंडामेंटल ऑफ पार्टनरशिप फर्म. द टॉपिक इज कमीशन और सैलरी टू ए पार्टनर. एज यू नो वेल, दीज टू आइटम्स अपीयर्स इन द डेबिट साइड ऑफ पीएल अप्रोप्रिएशन अकाउंट एंड इट इज क्रेडिटेड टू partners capital account if it is provided as per the partnership deed. And there are two method to calculate the commission that is very important. First is as a percentage of net profit before charging the commission. This topic we already dealt in class 11th. There are two formula to calculate commission. It depends upon the question, how the question is asked to you. If the net profit is given before charging commission, then what formula you will apply? Take the net profit before commission that is given in the question, rate of commission divided by 100. So this is applicable when net profit is before charging such commission. If in the second case, if net profit is given after charging such commission, then see the formula will change. What will be the formula? Net profit before commission into rate divided by 100 plus rate of commission. I think you can recall that previous year topic, manager's commission, the same formula you will apply here also. If commission is committed by the firm to be paid to partner, then you see whether the net profit is given before charging such commission or net profit is given after charging such commission. Accordingly, you will apply the formula. Now, next topic is treatment of manager commission. Manager of the firm may be given commission on the basis of either on sales or on net profit. It must be noted that such commission is charged against profit. So you must be very clear with the topic charge against profit and appropriation of profit. So charge against profit is the item of PL account, not the PL appropriation account. If it is given in the question, you just show this item in PL account. And if net profit is given before charging such manager commission, then what you have to do? First, you deduct this commission from net profit, then you transfer that net profit to the credit side of PL appropriation account. So this treatment is very important. You be careful while preparing PL appropriation account. And then this year next topic, rent paid to a partner. Interest on partner's loan that we have already discussed, it is not a part of PL appropriation account. Similarly, rent paid to a partner is also a charge against profit. So it is an item of PL account, not PL appropriation account. And if net profit is given before charging interest on rent, then which profit you will take or transfer to credit side of PL appropriation? First, you have to deduct rent from net profit, then you transfer the profit. After deducting rent, that profit will be transferred to the credit side of PL appropriation account. So this, you be careful how the question is asked to you. And one of the very technical topic, and definitely you will get the question from this topic, past adjustment. So as I already discussed in the class, once again I am repeating this topic. Ki, if suppose as per the partnership deed, it is not distributed, the profit is not distributed, it is just simply distributed either in profit sharing ratio or even sometime without considering the correct ratio, it is distributed equally. So what kind of mistake is suppose like omission. Omission means no interest on capital is allowed, no salary or commission is given to partners as per the partnership deed, or the ratio is higher or lower, whatever. So this how this is as the profit of the firm is distributed among the partner, but not in a correct way. So this error only affect partner's capital account. And partner's capital account, some partner is excessively credited and some partner is credited by short amount. Then instead of again preparing the final account, it is better to pass one adjustment entry at the end of the accounting period so that this error can be rectified in the coming accounting period. So just by those partner who are excessively credited is now debited, and a partner who is credited by short amount, he will be credited to rectify this error. So how to rectify this error? First is there are two methods. First, to pass an adjustment entry, or through pass adjustment entries through PL adjustment account. So generally first method is very popular and we usually follow first method, pass an adjustment entry, and that debit the partner's capital account, those who are having excess amount, that amount, and credit the partner who is having a short amount. So let us discuss this topic first method, because this method is usually we follow while passing the adjustment entry. So let us see in detail. Under this method, a statement is prepared to determine the net effect of all the past adjustment, and then a single entry is passed for the net amount. This method is generally preferred. As I said also, such error do not affect the total profit of the firm. They only affect the division of profit among the individual partners. So there is no need to prepare the final account. But the without affecting final account, we just rectifying the error simply by passing one adjustment entry made in the partner's capital or current account, as the case may be. When current account will involve, when you are following the fixed method, then excess and short amount is adjusted by involving current account. And if you are following fluctuating method, then you will involve partner's capital account. And if nothing is specified regarding the method, then you know well that you will involve capital account. Current account only be involved if it is specified in the question that partners have fixed capital. Somewhere if fixed is specified, then you will involve current account for passing the adjustment entry. And as entry will be debit capital or current account of the partner who has credited in excess. If excess amount is given to that partner, now he will be debited. And a partner who have been debited and credit the partner who has been shorted by the amount. Here it is mistakenly written debited in excess. It is wrong. Means if he has having a short amount, then he must be credited. So how you will, what are the steps to get the net effect, that we have already discussed. Once again, let us repeat, because this topic is very important, and this year also question came on this topic, 4 marks question. Just now I will show you in this video only what question asked on this topic. First step, calculate the amount which should be, means what should a partner is entitled to get as per the agreement, like he was being committed that he will get interest on capital, interest on drawing will also be charged, salary, share of profit. So first you find out what amount he should be given, and what already recorded by way and what actually he is credited with the amount of interest on capital, interest on salary, salary or share of profit. So the difference between step 1 and step 2 should be and already. You know the difference between should be, what he is entitled to get, and the second step, what he actually received. That difference will give you the excess and short amount. Find out the difference. And if a partner received excess, in the fourth step, you will get the excess and short amount. Who received excess and partner who received short, then you will pass the entry. Excess with what amount will be debited, that partner will be debited with that amount, and short, that partner will be credited with short amount. So this 5 step is very important. First, what he should entitled to get, what he actually received, then find out the difference, that will give you the excess and short amount, and that excess, that partner who received the excess money will be debited, and a partner who received short amount, he will be now credited, and this way we will rectify the error. So this topic should be very clear. And what are the generally errors occurred, like there is a omission of interest on capital, there is a omission of interest on drawing is to be charged, there is no salary or commission is given to a partner. So this type of errors generally we find that is to be rectified now by simply passing an adjustment entry. Now, that we have already discussed, now come to the let us discuss some of the board based questions, and even I will show you what kind of question this year, only 2020, asked on this topic. Whatever I already taught you, let us check your understanding, how much you have understood. See the first question of this year, 2020. Give the meaning of liability of partnership as a feature of partnership. You think about it, as we have discussed, one of the feature partners are having what kind of liability? Unlimited liability. Any liability arises, either a partner individually or jointly liable to pay the liability. So simply you will write unlimited liability of a partners, either he will bear personally or jointly by the partner. By writing this, you will get 1 marks. And see the second question. It is a topic of change in profit sharing ratio. This year only this question asked. See the question. Red, blue and white were partners in a firm sharing profit in the ratio of 1:2:2. Okay. And they decided to share future profit in the ratio of 7:5:3 with effect from 1st April 2019. Their balance sheet as on that date showed a balance of 22,500 in deferred revenue expenditure account. Can you tell me where this item will appear? In the asset side. The amount to be debited respectively to the capital account of red, blue and white for writing off deferred revenue expenditure. So there are 4 options given. You have to say which option is correct. By what ratio this 22,500 will be written off now? Can you tell me? That is old ratio. 1:2:2. Can you tell me which option is correct? That is B. 4,500, 9,000. So this way question will be asked. This is of 1 marks question. Hardly you will get 30 or 40 seconds to give the answer. So that is speed you must check, how much time you are taking to solve this 1 marks question. Now see another question. board based questions of past adjustment. See, Ram, Mohan and Sohan were partners sharing profit in the ratio of 2:1:1. Okay, Ram withdrew ₹3,000 per month and Mohan withdrew ₹4,000 per month. Every month, interest on drawing at the rate of 6% per annum was charged. Whereas the partnership deed was silent about interest on drawings. So what you are understanding with this two line? Partnership deed silent means there is a no provision to charge interest on drawing, but then also this interest on drawings were charged from the partners. So show your working note clearly and pass the necessary adjustment entry to rectify the error. See, your working note is very important. Out of this 4 marks, 3 marks is given for your working note and 1 marks is given for your adjustment entry. This is the marks distribution, step marking is there. So can you tell me if what is the relevant of this per annum, what average period you will take for calculating interest on drawing? That is 4000, Mohan ka 4000 into 12, 48000. 48000 is the total drawings during the year of Mohan into 6/100 into 6/12. Why 6/12? Because per annum board is specified here. So average period you will take 6 months. Similarly, Ram's total drawing 3000 into 12, that is 36000 into 6/100 into 6/12. This is the first step. First you calculate what interest on drawing is charged from Ram and Mohan. So charged means, if you have remembered the table that I demonstrated in my previous video, Ram, Mohan and Sohan, three columns you will make and one column for the firm. So of course interest on drawing is debited, but it is debited, already debited, but it should not be debited. So what you have to write, interest on drawing debited, now credited, you just cancel it. So while writing in the debit column, write it in the credit column first. And in the firm's account, it should not be written in the credit side. It should be written in the debit side because it is wrongly credited. So while canceling, it should be debited now. And that balancing figure of the firm is coming in the credit side, that is a loss. And that amount is distributed in which ratio? 2:1:1. You just do the same, distribute it into 2:1:1, that, and you will write in the partners column debit side. So which side is bigger, accordingly you will mark debit or credit. Then you will get the entry. That what will be the entry? Ram, Mohan and I'm just giving this question as a homework, and in the next video I will show you the explanation. You just first you try your effort to solve this question. Let's see how many of you are able to solve this question, because while correcting the board copy, 80 or more than 80% students are not able to solve this question. Let us check, my student, how many of you are able to solve this question, and check your understanding also, how much you have understood. So this is my homework. Okay, you just write it down, this question, in your copy. I have given you enough time to note down this 5-line question. I think you have written all the questions, this question. And this, see here, or is given. This time, this question and one more choice is given. Either you attempt this question or you can attempt this question. That is PL appropriation. It is most of the student, I think 90% student attempted this question, and the good one attempted that question, but even He scored 72-73 marks and just 4 marks was deducted because that question they attempted incorrectly. So you just see whether you are able to solve that question or not. And this question is also somehow someone are confused. See, what is that question? Yadu, Vidu and Radhu are partner, okay. And their profit sharing ratio is 4:3:3. A fixed capital, here it is, fixed capital is written 1st April, that is 2018. Amount is here mentioned, capital 9 lakhs, 5 lakhs and 4 lakhs. These are the capital of three partners. And on 1st November 2018, Yadu gave a loan of 80,000 to the firm as per the partnership agreement. So, as you know, partner's loan is not the part of PL appropriation account. So, don't get confused at this interest on partner's loan also. You just show it into the partner's capital account. You don't get part PL appropriation account. Don't get confused. And what are the adjustments? That partners are entitled to get interest on capital at the rate of 6% per annum. My objective type question, can you tell me interest on capital is calculated on which capital? Opening capital, closing capital, opening capital. And interest on partners drawing is to be charged at the rate of 8% per annum. If per annum is specified, then you must apply average period 6 months. That these are the some of the important points you just keep in mind. See, firm earned a profit 2,53,000 after interest on Yadu's loan. That means ki there is no requirement to do any adjustment relating to interest on Yadu's loan. Simply you just take this net profit to the credit side of PL appropriation account, that is 2,53,000. And while correcting the copy, I have seen most of the student has calculated interest on loan, deducted it from the net profit, then transferred it to the PL appropriation account. That shows that student is very confused. It is already mentioned after interest on Yadu's loan. Then what net profit you will take? 2,53,000. There is no question of confusion. Now, partners drawing already given 80,000, 70,000, 50,000. Then what is your first step? Calculate interest on capital of three partners. Already mentioned 6%, 9,000, 6% of 9,000. 9 lakhs, 5 lakhs, 4 lakhs. First step. Second step, calculate interest on drawing. That is mentioned 8% on 80,000, 70,000, 50,000. And also you must multiply it by 6 by 12. Don't forget this, because most of the student has done simply they calculated the 8% and that amount they have shown in the PL appropriate. I'm just telling you what kind of mistake generally student do. You please don't do this. And then simply you just write in the debit side to interest on capital, Yadu, Vidu and Radha. For this you will get 1.5 marks. Net profit that you have transferred in the credit side, 2,53,000. For this you are getting half marks. And then interest on drawing that you have calculated is transferred to the credit side of PL appropriation account. That for that step you will get 1.5 marks. And half marks is for individual profit. After getting the balancing, comparing the debit and credit, the balancing figure is coming to the debit side. And that you just distribute it in the ratio specified in the question, 4:3:3. For this step, you are getting half marks. So this is a question of 4 marks. So I just given this current year question, and already we have discussed the topic PL appropriation account and this past adjustment entry. You just check your understanding, try to solve this question in your accounts copy and see how much you have understood. And if not, then please convey this message that how many of you have not understood or not able to solve this question, then I will show you the solution. So this is what all about this topic. Thank you so much.